Thank you for watching this video of our Epigeum's brand new program, Statistical Research Methods. Statistical Research Methods is a program which provides comprehensive, cross-disciplinary support for researchers who require a foundation or refresher in statistical methods. It's a resource designed to improve research confidence and motivation in contemporary statistical methods. Our team created this course with the help of our development group with 8 key members who are all leading higher education institutions. We also had a team of experts in the field, which comprised of authors of each module, reviewers, and our lead advisor, James Abdi. This team was integral to creating the finalized program, and we are grateful for their collaboration. Statistical Research Methods is available on a subscription basis via our Epigeum platform or on your institution's VLE. The screen recording for this video features content taken from the platform. So in this video, we're going to be taking you through some of the great interactive features of this course. Statistics covers a lot of advanced information, which is why we've aimed for both depth and breadth to give your researchers the best foundation and refresher possible in this area. Before your users take this course, there is a concise, pre-programmed diagnostic tool which highlights learner needs and offers a tailored approach at all levels. This diagnostic tool is right at the beginning. Users can use it to assess their confidence with different areas of statistical research methods and be directed to modules that best suit their needs. The tool is based around a selection of scenarios you may encounter as a researcher and is designed to help you identify where your strengths lie and which modules you should prioritize for your professional development. As you can see, it uses a scale to help users assess their confidence, then provides feedback after each answer. At the end of the tool, there is a summary which gives an overview of the modules that would be most useful for the user. Within the actual program, we have a variety of interactive activities to make the content and learning process as engaging as possible. These include video interviews, quick case studies, graphs, real-life scenarios, download pods, which contain software introductions, as well as the glossary. In modules with a lot of information, we've provided visual ways of digesting the information, including accordion boxes and match-up exercises to vary the learning. Important to note is that your users can take each module as many times as they would like, which makes it flexible and great for refreshing knowledge at the point of need throughout the year as they work on their research projects. So now let's take a closer look at a specific module in more detail. This module is about recognizing different types of data, visualizing data, and interpreting visualizations for single and combinations of variables. This feeds into the wider course benefit in that it provides key support for researchers to evaluate and interpret statistics and report on sound research findings. Users can navigate between each screen using arrows at the top right, and also by clicking into the menu at the top left, where they can go to specific screens. Each module starts with a screen on clear learning outcomes, where users can pinpoint what they'll be learning about. There's also guidance on how to use certain activities and clickable buttons. It also provides guidance on pods, which are additional learning opportunities on each screen. It's also worth noting that we have a text print version available for accessibility, which we have across all our modules. So on this screen, we can see an introduction to the module. The first activity we come across can select from this menu to discover dialogues between researchers, which you can navigate through the next button and then go back to the main menu for a new dialogue. There's a polling activity and you can select one or more of these options and vote on them and see what other users have voted for. This next screen is called Types of Data. You can click on the interactive activities to learn more about data types. Note how digestible the content is. We also have a pod with quick case studies where you can learn more about specific research projects to contextualize your learning. At the bottom here, we have a drag and drop activity which categorizes data types from different research projects. So this is an example of how our course provides active learning with feedback throughout. So note these pods along the right-hand side offering further information and guidance. These downloadable portfolio pods and datasets throughout the course allow learners to save activities and notes, to revisit in future to practice, refresh, and test their skills. So this third screen is called Exploratory Data Analysis with Descriptive Statistics. You can see there's a large table here where you can click to reveal the information in the table so that you can take it at the pace that suits your needs. So further down, we have a multiple choice quiz where users can select one of the answers and check to receive feedback on whether they've selected the right answer before navigating on to the next question. These small quizzes within a module means that learning is in bite-sized chunks. So this screen is about visualizing data. It introduces users to different methods of visualizing single variables with plots and histograms. The main reason for wanting to show this screen is for the pinpoint activities which we've made use of throughout the course. These are an accessible and intuitive way to present quite a lot of information, which is then supported with reflective activities and pods which link to examples of poor visualizations and more information on different types of visualization. This screen is called Visualizing Multiple Variables. As you can see, we have additional pinpoint graphics, which can each be selected and each label selected just as before. And further down, we have an activity where users are asked to fill in the missing words from each sentence. There's more information on the right-hand side to give users a little bit more context about what information they need to provide. At the end of each module, we realize it can be a lot to take in. That's why we include a specialized summary screen to recap on what has just been covered, reiterating the learning outcomes. We include a space here to record notes relevant to research projects specific to the learner. We also include a rate the statement section so learners know what they might need to refresh on later. As this course is online and fully flexible, this is where taking the course at the point of need can really help, as learners can return to any screens or concepts that require further study. This is the application screen. On this screen, we want to show you the screencast activities, which are a unique feature of this module. On the screencasts, there is a menu here, which helps you navigate to each of the six screencasts which are on this screen. The user isn't expected to watch all six of these. They're just there to support people who may be familiar with one software over another. So they can watch the Excel, Python, or the R version, depending on their familiarity, then navigate back to the menu and watch the next video for that same software. The screencasts have been produced to help guide users in an intuitive way through otherwise quite lengthy or complex information that wouldn't have been possible to implement into an activity. We've also provided software introduction pages in the downloads pod at the beginning of each module to help users learn about the different software if they are curious to learn a new one, or to help guide them if they are altogether unfamiliar. This screencast was created by our author, Glenn Williams. On these next screens, you'll find a resource bank and a reference page. We follow up each module with references so you can see our program is based on extensive research within the field, as well as real-life scenarios. Our program therefore addresses the current statistics in context, taking the interdisciplinary research environment into consideration. On the final screen of each module, the user will find a module quiz. These consist of four questions covering material from the module and can be taken more than once, in which case a new set of questions will appear. They are all multiple choice, so you can go down and select one answer from each of these questions before checking the answers at the bottom. Now I've taken you through a module from start to finish to showcase an example of what your learners will encounter. What I want to do now is showcase a few examples of other activities and interactive features that we haven't yet seen. So on this screen, I have clicked into Module 4, Sampling, Estimation, and Generalization of Results. We have video interviews throughout this course, They're a mix of author-led video interviews and interviews with statistics lecturers from the UK and also Australia. We also have video interviews in four of the modules, as we felt it would be a real benefit to the course with lots of complex information for students and early years researchers to hear about common issues using statistics in practice from a variety of academics in different disciplines. This video is in a pod, so it's optional, but we've split the video into smaller parts to make them more digestible. In this interview, the users will learn about sampling methods and questionnaire design. Here's a screen from another one of our modules, False Positives, False Negatives, the Need for Reproducibility of Results. As you can see here, there's another video interview, this time with our lead advisor, James Abdi. So this screen is from Module 8, explaining the world of variation through linear modelling. The introductory page is full of illustrations to help breathe life into the content. This module is quite heavy with data, graphs, and calculations, so the illustrations are also there to make the screen feel less intimidating. Rather than just being presented with data, the images hopefully get the learners thinking about how the content relates to the world around them. These illustrations were created using AI with help from Sage Design. It's our first time using AI for illustrations, and we're really happy with the results. If I scroll down to the final activity, you can select each one of the people to view their dialogue and their thoughts on research questions. This screen is taken from our ninth module, Fundamentals of Data Management. As you can see, the first activity is an accordion activity, which provides definitions of key concepts in a bite-sized and digestible format that the learner can take at their own pace. At the bottom of this screen is a matching activity where learners are asked to match each concept with its definition by selecting the boxes on the left, the boxes on the right. When you subscribe to Statistical Research Methods, our dedicated team provide ongoing assistance with the installation, promotion, and delivery of programs, as well as regular community of practice events. Alongside this, we also provide promotional resources such as posters, email templates, and social media imagery to help you spread the message and encourage your researchers to access this resource. Now I've gone through a short demonstration of our program, I wanted to briefly touch on our blended learning resources, which are part of the package offered by our course. These act as a guide for course conveyors who might wish to host in-person sessions or workshops alongside our content. You can see they're packed with ideas for discussion and activities, fitting your institution's unique needs. Thank you for watching this demonstration. As you can see, we've aimed to make this program as engaging as possible. We hope your researchers find this content accessible, engaging, and helps provide them with the support and statistics that they need for successful research projects. To find out more, please scan this QR code or click the links below this video.